Wish I had a last swig of whiskey. You're the mask guy who's been taking down all the lords and ladies. No way through this gate unless you've got the sewer key. Only one place to get that key, and I wouldn't go there. Not for all the gold in Dunwall Tower. Not again. Maybe you could pull it off, though. Something attacked us in the distillery. It used the rats. I know it sounds crazy. And then it run back under the streets. So we come down here to kill it, Slackjaw leading the way. Went bad. I barely crawled out. Don't know what happened to Slackjaw. He had the sewer key, though.
They left in great haste, scattering like insects, eager to bore into the nests you made for them.
The nasty fat and sinew, and carve a pretty song on your bones.
Hey! Someone kill this crazy witch! I could make you rich!
Quiet now. Granny needs to concentrate.
Don't kill me. Granny Rag, stop! Stop what you're doing. Can't we at least talk about it?
My knife's gotta be nice and sharp to cut into your skeleton, Slackjaw. Nice and sharp. There's my love. Are you ready to help get Slackjaw's bones? Granny has some birthday gifts for you. I've been saving them up in case you ever came back to me. Not going to help Granny? Well, I'm disappointed. You better leave.
Mass man, fancy you showing up down here. Look at the pickle I'm in. Word is all over the street about your little secret, Corvo. You're the one that acts the Empress. Makes sense why you run around wearing that mask. Maybe you could help me out, since we're friends and all.
Oh no. I'll kill
you. Can't kill her with a sword. Not with a sword, you can't.
Look around. There's a cameo of a young girl. It's her. Destroy it with the furnace. Says in one of her books it's the only way to get rid of her brother.
Gnaw his flesh away, my little birds.
Wanna know something funny? When we were kids, we were all scared of Granny Rags. Thought she was a terrible witch. Then we grew up and figured she was just a sad old lady. We were right the first time. Now ain't that funny? I owe you. This won't even the score, but it's all I got left.
Luck to you, Corvo.
find your way into such interesting places, Corvo. At the eye of the storm, raging between granny rags and this man who has lived his whole life with a cleaver in one hand and a bottle in the other. Crawling out of those flooded ruins, winding your way back to the pub where you last saw Emily. Where is she now? How does it feel now, knowing your allies betrayed you? Strange how there's always a little more innocence left to lose. And Dowd, the man who killed the Empress. You had him in the palm of your hand, and you let him walk away? You fascinate me.
Please, no! Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed, except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survived. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore, but I'll bet he's still out there, looking for you, is my guess. At first, Pendleton said it was time for our bonus. Havelock stood behind them, and at the signal, he shot them each in the back of the head. Just like the target drills he used to. Lydia barely had time to scream. I would be dead too. Except Wallace told me I wouldn't be getting anything. Pendleton kept apologizing, saying that no one could ever know about the things they'd done. Martin was drinking and seemed sad. The Admiral was about to shoot Callista. Then he mumbled something about owing her uncle, Captain Kurnow, a debt. They said it was time for Sokolov, and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that. Emily was there when the killing started. Poor child. I hope she hid her eyes. The Admiral said that Martin was right. I guess they talked about it. And they started to worry they'd get executed for all that they'd done, going after the Lord Regent and his allies. I suppose it's why they've poisoned you too. I thought Lydia would squeal on me at the end. She just told Havelock to screw himself. And died. Lydia's the only one.
What a day, huh?
Gonna be a great party.
I was only a kid at the last coronation. We even make it this day. Will you look at this mess?
Relax. One of the officers said he was dead. Poisoned, thrown in the river. If you ask me, he's long gone. Threw the mask in the river, left town.
That's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. You have to understand the criminal mind. I hear they had to hide the Caldwin girl from him the whole time they were working with him. I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
The criminal mind, huh? So what's he doing now?
Waiting. He's probably watching us right now. That crazy mask.
Could the city get any worse?
Yes, of course.
Got you now.
Promotion for the man who kills this one.
Call out to each other if you've got you now.
It's refreshing to converse with someone on my own level.
Couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the Academy was a crime against natural philosophy itself.
Which you might have pointed out at the time. But it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask you...
about the elixir, yes. And I need to discuss your tonic. Why have you not tried the homeopathic solution?
And where am I to find the subjects? I can't recruit from prisons as you do. But it's forced me to work with another agent derived from...
the river crusts, yes. I'd guessed as much. But I think our approaches may reinforce each other. This is what we've been lacking thus far. Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. This city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, nearly rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields of battle with ease, but Sokolov and I are not as gifted in the same way. Without the Arc Pylon, it is only a matter of time before they put an end to us. We can get this device working, or you can go out and remove our enemies one by one, whichever you think is best.
Look out, we got someone skulking around. I'll write to her again. She has to see reason.
Look out, we got someone skulking around.
I'll flush you out!
What?
Why is no one making rounds over here?
It's better.
Why is no one making rounds over here?
We know you're here.
You keep going.
Pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? As you wish, Corvo. We will be far away before any of them regain their senses. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honors?
When this Arc Pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
Look out, get a prowler.
Description. A device like this will ensure Dunwall's security for a century.
Well, Corvo, I hope we can be considered colleagues again. You were condemned, I was kidnapped. Men like us rise above such things. As to the good Admiral, I believe men such as Havelock start with high-minded intentions. Same with Martin, and maybe even Pendleton, though I suspect he was just lazy. But no one is prepared for the sheer seductive influence of being so close to real power.
We once discussed a system of signals to be used in Emily's tower for communication across the river. I wonder if he remembers that.
So
Emily banged her head in the confusion. They dragged her crying into the waiting boat. She called your name.
Well, I knew it was too good to be true. Seems that the conspiracy tried to use old Piero for their own gain and then discard him. But they have erred and delivered to me an ally almost as brilliant as myself. Old Sokolov and I will hole up here until we can blast the ruppians outside and make a clear out of it.
It all up. Then they took Emily with them and they left. I couldn't do anything to protect her. Please find her. Make her safe. All his talk of being an honorable military man, but... Havlok will use Emily like a puppet to his own advantage. Something changed in the Admiral as soon as the Lord Regent died. It had been building up. Martin was acting strange, going quiet if any of us were near, whispering late into the night with Havlok and Pendleton while you were out doing the real work. I think they realized they were one step away from holding the same position the Lord Regent had, and worried they'd be held accountable for what they did here, as the Loyalists. They would have killed me too, but Havlok spared me. Out of respect for my uncle, I believe. Please, talk to Samuel and the others. Someone must know where they're going. Find Emily. She's suffered through so much, and she's got no one else on her side except you. Samuel set this here in case you returned. You can use it to call him. He said he'd come quickly. Hopefully there's a place he can dock where the watch won't see her.
She is Callista Kerr now. She has learned to defend herself.
Now that you've eliminated the city watch, I can find my way out of here. But there's no way I can help Emily the way you can. I saw Samuel on the river earlier. I'm sure he'll take you where you need to go.
I'll make what you need as long as I have the necessary materials. Goodbye, Corvo. I wish to apologize for what was done to you. It seems that holding all the pieces and standing a step from the throne changed something in the others. Something I don't understand. Don't underestimate Havlok, Corvo. He'll be waiting.
This Piero of yours, a strange mind. But then my own is strange as well. If there is a cure to the plague, I believe we will find it. The old Empress would have liked that. She was a strange one. Stranger, I think, than you ever knew. But such things are past. And this new Empress, she's a strange one, too.
Thought I'd find you here. It never pays to bet against you, does it? I saw the signal. I knew you'd be back, Corvo. I knew it. We'll need to get out of here soon. The Admiral controls the military now, Martin's high overseer, and Pendleton's in favor with the aristocracy and Parliament. They need Emily, of course. But if Havelock senses that it's all about to fall down around him, who knows what he's liable to do? Good. Then it's one more trip across the river to where it meets the sea. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see. This is it, sir. I suspect Havelock Martin and Lord Pendleton landed there a while ago and went into the lighthouse. Knowing them, they're not giving up without a fight. I remember hearing the Admiral and Martin talking about this place as where they'd hold up if they had to. Anybody going in has to breach the fort, the gatehouse, and there's only one way to the top. All I can say is that it's been a pleasure serving with you. Maybe after all this is settled, we'll see each other again. Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do. Give my best to Emily. After she's on the throne, she won't have time for an old man like me. I knew you were sharp, Corvo. Managed to get through all this mess without losing sight of what really matters. For that, I respect you. The city's gonna pull itself up, I believe. Too many good people here to let it all turn to ashes. I'd best be going. The battlefield's no place for an old sailor like me. That time is long past. Good luck, my friend.
People like the rivermen. They spread their nets wide and pull up all manner of things. The sweet, the deadly, the poisonous. All together in one catch.
Thank you. replicants as weak as the last set?
No.
I need shit from you.
Ugh. Yes, of course.
Talents wasted until it found its fate.
This is all Martin's fault.
We hadn't helped Corvo get out of prison. Corvo hadn't been so damn good at his job. We hadn't gotten greedy and afraid. Always too sure that was my problem. Never hesitated. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. This is yours. The key to Emily's cell. She'll be glad to see you. You made quite an impression on her. Did you know that? She asked about you constantly. Where you were. What you've been doing. I told her. In the end, I told her everything. From the start, when we had such noble goals in mind. To the end, when we were afraid, fighting in secrecy about who we could trust and who we had to kill. Arguing over who would act as new Lord Regent.
Who is that? Admiral Havelock?
Eyes wide.
If you don't let me out, I'm going to make you stand in a corner until you learn how to behave. Corvo?
Go ahead.
Who's there?
Kill me or take me to Coalbridge Prison. Make your choice. She'll be watching.
Guard!
They devise new ways to detain the elements. They left in great haste, scattering like insects, eager to bore into the nests you made for them.
Such things, cowardly things, and I'm ashamed of. How could anyone ever forgive us? Would they, even if things are better? No, that's not how it works. Once the bureaucrats step in, everything gets muddy. If anyone ever knew, we'd all lose our heads for this. So no one can know. And could we ever control Emily with Corvo around? That's the question that sticks in my mind. We need to make our final move, and we need to make it cleanly. No loose ends. Only a few in the know. The ones with the most to lose.
Emily banged her head in the confusion. They dragged her crying into the waiting boat. She called your name.
Corvo! I knew you'd come. Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is, with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. Decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than a royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Long enough for all of the big and the small. Well, the taller they stand, well, the harder they fall. We live for today, but we die for the next. With blood in our veins, in the air, in our chest, or we step into war with our hearts on the line. The dirt on our boots, it shakes free over time. Is a distant aroma at best, a withering smile that's stuck deep in your vest. The night air, it wraps its fingers around your body, it shakes from a now distant sound. Oh, the sound of her voice, a sweet for me. Played over and over until you are free.
Tear at the ones who brought the disease.